Hello children, today we will learn a new topic from English to lesson number 4, direct and indirect speech. Children, there are two ways of reporting the words of a speaker. One way is through direct speech and other one is indirect speech. Now let's know about direct speech. What is direct speech? When we quote the actual words of a speaker without any change is called what? Direct speech. When we quote the actual words of the speaker without any change, it is called direct speech. The exact words of the speaker are put within inverted commas. The reporting verb introduces the reported speech. See the example, children. Ravi said, I am very busy. What Ravi said? I am very busy. Whatever he said, without any change, it is quoted. So, this is in direct speech. Okay? What Ravi said? I am very busy. So, whatever Ravi said, it is quoted as it is. So, it is in direct speech. And the exact words of the speaker are put within inverted commas. Whatever Ravi said, we have to put it with inverted commas. Okay? So, I am very busy. That is what Ravi said. So, we have to put this in inverted commas. Okay? Here we have to start the inverted commas and have to end. Okay? Then the first letter should be capital letter. Okay? Ravi said. Said is what? Reporting verb. Said is the verb, right? And here it is reporting. Ravi said. So, said is the reporting verb and Ravi is the speaker. And said is the reporting verb. I am very busy and that is what Ravi said, right? So, that these are the quoted words and you should put in what? Inverted commas. And after the reporting verb, you have to put a comma and should start with capital letter. And you have to put those words in inverted commas. So, this is what direct speech. So, what is direct speech, children? When we quote the actual words of the speaker without any change, whatever the speaker said, we are quoting as it is, without any change. This is called what? Direct speech. And we should put the exact words of the speaker in inverted commas. And the reporting verb introduces the reported speech. So, this here, Ravi is the speaker and said is the reporting verb. And what Ravi said? I am very busy. And these are the quoted words which should be put within inverted commas. Okay? See, I am very busy, Ravi said. The same sentence. See, I am very busy. Here is the end mentioned, right? First, Ravi said. You can write the quoted words in the beginning or in the end as well. Okay? Both ways you can write. Ravi said, I am very busy. The quoted words are mentioned in the end, right? But in the next example, you see, I am very busy, Ravi said. Here at the end, the quoted words had come in the beginning. Okay? The same only. I am very busy. Put the inverted commas, put a comma and Ravi said. In both ways, you can write a direct speech. The quoted words can come in the beginning as well as at the end. Okay? Now, let us see what is indirect speech. When we report or narrate the speech, that is, give the summary of the words, not the exact words of the speaker, is called what? Indirect speech. So, indirect speech means what? We report or narrate the summary. Okay, whatever the speaker said, we are narrating it shortly. Okay, not the exact words of the speaker we don't use. Okay. We report or narrate the speech, that is, give the summary of the words, not the exact words of the speaker. And it is called what? Indirect speech. See here, Ravi said that he was very busy. What here Ravi said? He said, I am very busy, right? I am very busy is the what? The word he said, right? Now, when we say in indirect speech, Ravi said that he was very busy. So, what are the changes happen in indirect speech? Ravi said that it is the same, right? The speaker and the reporting verb did not change. And you can find what? That conjunction that is introduced, right? That is a conjunction. So, conjunction that is introduced. produce. And after that, he, right? That is introduced conjunction. He here, I, right? First person, I changed to he, right? Here, what pronoun changes? And next word here, am. Am is in what present tense, right? And here, what it became? Was. Became in past tense, right? Here, present tense changed to past tense. The tense changed. Okay? So, in indirect speech, conjunction that is introduced, pronoun changes, and the tense also changed. Okay? So, this is what indirect speech. When we report or narrate the speech, that is, give the summary of the words, not the exact words of the speaker, is called what? Indirect speech. Okay? Remember the following while changing direct speech to indirect speech. We have to remember some rules while changing direct to indirect speech. The reported speech is not placed within the inverted commas. Correct, right? Here, can you find any inverted commas? Here it was mentioned, right? Here, inverted commas. So, whatever we have written in indirect speech, there is no inverted commas. So, this is what the main rule that we have to follow, that in reported speech, in indirect speech, the reported speech is not placed within the inverted commas. No inverted commas are used in indirect speech. No comma is placed after the reporting verb. This also correct, right? After the reporting verb, is there any comma? No. But here it is right. In direct speech, after the reporting verb, you can find, you have to put a comma. But when it comes to indirect speech, after reporting verb, no comma is required. Okay? We should not put comma and no inverted commas also. Okay? The reported speech is introduced by the conjunction that. That is correct, right? The indirect speech is reported with the conjunction that. Next, question mark and the mark of exclamation are not used. Okay? If question mark or exclamation marks are used in direct speech, then when we convert it into indirect speech, then we should not put question mark or exclamation mark. Okay? Instead of that, we have to put full stop. Imperative, interrogative, and exclamatory sentences are turned to assertive sentence. So, question mark, exclamation mark, interrogative sentences, question marks, right? So, if you find any of these in direct speech, then when we convert into indirect speech, these should not be mentioned there. Instead of that, we have to put full stop. Okay? So, these are the rules that we have to remember while changing direct speech to indirect speech. First one is what? The reported speech is not placed within inverted commas. Whatever the speaker said, we should not write in inverted commas. Okay? There is no inverted commas while writing in indirect speech. And no comma is placed after the reporting verb. After the reporting verb, no comma should be placed. Next, question mark, exclamation mark, imperative, interrogative, and exclamatory sentences are turned into assertive sentences. Okay? Children, next is tense change. Reporting verb in the present tense. Let's see, when the reporting verb is in the present tense, the tense of the verb in the reported speech does not change. What is the reporting verb here? See the example. The teacher says the English test is on Tuesday. What is the reporting verb here? Says is the reporting verb here, right? And if the reporting verb is in present tense, then the reported speech also will be in present tense only. There is no changes. Okay? So, see how we can write in indirect speech. The teacher says that the English test is on Tuesday. Here, reporting verb did not change. When the reporting verb is in present tense, When we change to indirect speech, the teacher says that the conjunction that is introduced right after the reporting verb. So the teacher says that the English test is on Tuesday. Here the verb is in present tense itself. We are not changing to any other tense. Okay. So if the reporting verb is in present tense, the reported speech also should be in present tense itself. You should not make any changes here. Okay. The reported speech does not change. Next, reporting verb in the past tense. If the reporting verb in the past tense, then what happens to the tense? If the reporting verb is in the past tense, change the verbs in the reported speech as shown. First is the present tense in direct speech changes to the past tense in the indirect speech. If the speech is in present tense, if the direct speech is in present tense, then we have to change it into past tense. If the reporting verb is in past tense, okay? See, simple present tense becomes simple past tense. See the example here. If the reporting verb is in past tense, in direct speech, they said, we play football daily. What is the reporting verb here? Said, right? And it is in past tense. Say, present tense, said, past tense. So, if the reporting verb is in past tense and we play football daily, this is in present tense, right? Simple present tense. So, when we convert into indirect speech, we have to change the direct speech into present tense into simple past tense. See how it is changed? They said that they played football daily. They said that conjunction is added. We became they. Okay? Here pronoun change. Play. Verb play in the present tense. Simple past tense is used. Play football daily. Okay? So, we should not put comma after the reporting speech and no inverted commas. Okay? So, this is how we have to change from direct speech into indirect speech if the reporting verb is in the past tense. Okay? If the reporting verb is in the past tense and the direct speech is in simple present tense, change it into simple past tense. Next, present continuous becomes past continuous. Okay? If the direct speech is in present continuous, it will just change into past continuous tense. See the example. John said, I am going to church. Sentence in past tense, right? Reporting verb all in past tense, okay? Then if the direct speech is in present continuous tense, you know, right? See children, you should know present, past and future tense properly, okay? All the continuous form, everything. Then only you will be able to understand this, okay? I am going. This is what in present continuous tense, right? So it will change into what? Past continuous tense when we convert into indirect speech. So, John said that I became he and going became what? Past continuous tense, was going to church. John said that he was going to church. Next, present perfect becomes past perfect. See the example in direct speech. He said, I have done my job. How can we? I have done this in what? Present perfect tense, right? Now, how can we change into past perfect in indirect speech? He said that he have became had. Okay, had done his job. Okay, we should not put comma or inverted commas and no capital letter here. Okay, here all will change into simple present perfect will change into past perfect. Next. The past tense in the direct speech, in the indirect speech, changes the indirect speech in the following manner. The past tense in the direct speech, if the direct speech is in past tense, then changes in the indirect speech is in the following manner. See, simple past becomes past perfect. What we learned earlier here, when the direct speech is in present tense, simple present, we change to simple past. If it is in present continuous, we'll change to past continuous tense. If it is in present perfect, we'll change into past perfect. Then, if the direct speech is in past tense itself, then simple past becomes past perfect. See the example. Amit said that he, so sorry. Amit said, I bought a pen yesterday. Here, I bought is what? Already in past tense, right? So, if the direct speech is in past tense, then we have to change into past perfect tense in indirect speech. See, Amit said that, I became he. Bought already in past tense. Past perfect means had bought. Had bought a pen. Yesterday became the day before. Okay? These are the changes you have to make while writing in indirect speech if the direct speech is in past tense. Clear, children? Next, past continuous become past perfect continuous tense. If the direct speech is in past continuous tense, then it will change into past perfect continuous tense. See the example. Kabir said, I was playing cricket. This is in what tense? Past continuous tense, right? Past continuous tense will change into past perfect continuous tense. See, Kabir said that he had been playing cricket. Had been playing is what? In past perfect continuous tense. Had plus been plus verb plus ing we have learned, right? So these are the forms. If you learn, then only it will be useful for you. You will know how to change from direct to indirect speech. Okay? The change in tenses. So children, these are the reporting verb in the past tense. If the verb is in past tense, change the verbs in reported speech. If the present tense in the direct speech will change into past tense in indirect speech. The past tense in direct speech changes into indirect speech in the following manner. That is what simple past becomes past perfect and past continuous becomes past perfect continuous tense. Okay? Children, now take page number 62. I will read this. Some other changes that take place if the reporting verb is in the past tense are, okay, there are some changes that take place the reporting verb is in the past tense. See, in direct speech, reporting verb is will means in indirect speech, it will become would, okay, will change into would. Must will become had to. May will become might in indirect speech. Here will become there. These will become those. Today will become that day. Last night will become the previous night in indirect speech. Tomorrow in direct speech will become the next day or the following day. Can in direct speech will become could in indirect speech. Shall will become should. Now will become then. This will become that. Ago will become before in indirect speech. Tonight will become that night. Yesterday will become the day before or the previous day. Then next week will become the week after or the following week. Children, this you have to learn. Then only you'll be able to change the reporting verb from direct speech into indirect speech. Okay? Now children, take page number 64. We will do exercise A. Okay? Rewrite the following sentences using quotation marks wherever necessary. You have to rewrite the sentences given here using proper quotation marks wherever necessary. First one is, my name is Sunita, said the girl. It's in direct speech. Where you have to put quotation marks, inverted commas? Here, my name is Sunita, right? This is what the girl said. So, my name is Sunita is in, it should be in inverted commas. So, write down, my name is Sunita, and put inverted commas, then comma, said the girl, full stop. Next, the man said, comma, it was a cold rainy night when I lost my cat. The man said, what he said, it was a cold rainy night when I lost my cat. So, this should be put in inverted comma. So, write down, the man said, comma, it was a cold rainy night when I lost my cat. Put it in inverted commas. Next, how far away is Hyderabad, asked the man. How far away is Hyderabad should be put in inverted commas. So, write down how far away is Hyderabad and put in inverted commas and ask the man. Right. You have to put here comma. Next, the doctor asked, are you feeling very weak?
You can write the doctor asked, comma, are you feeling very weak? Put it in inverted commas. It's in direct speech, right? What doctor said, it should be put in inverted commas. Next, let us go for a walk, suggested Mrs. Mala. So, let us go for a walk. That should be put in quotation marks or inverted commas. Then put comma, suggested Mrs. Mala. Just copy the same. Next, what time is the party? Asked Kabil. So, you can put inverted commas for what time is the party. Put inverted commas and comma, ask Kabil. Next, Aslam told his mother, I don't want to go to school. What he told his mother? I don't want to go to school. So, this should be put in quotation marks. So, write Aslam told his mother, comma, I don't want to go to school. Put in quotation marks and put full stop. Next, the messenger said, alas, the king is dead. What he said? Alas, the king is dead. So, you have to put those in inverted commas. So, you write the messenger said, comma, alas, start the inverted commas. Alas, the king is dead. Put full stop and complete the inverted commas. Next, the teacher said, stop running in the corridor. What teacher said? Stop running in the corridor. So, this should be put in inverted commas or quotation. So, write, the teacher said, comma, stop running the corridor. After comma, you should put capital letter. You should write capital letter. Put it in inverted commas, okay? Next, he said, mother, are you not going to make sweets? What he said? Mother, are you not going to make sweets, right? So, you write, he said, comma, mother, start the inverted commas, mother, comma, are you not going to make sweets? Then, close the inverted commas. Okay, children, I hope you all understood. Changes in pronouns, I will take in the next session, okay? If you have any doubt, you can ask me in the interactive session. Thank you.